Dear students, in my this presentation on inclusive education, I will cover the main areas related to the field of inclusive education, that is, problems or barriers in inclusion, educational provisions for inclusion, and factors determining the success of inclusive classrooms. So, let's start. Inclusion in the real world, realities on the ground. National Sample Survey on Disability 2018 reported 2.2% disability in India. So if we look at the actual data, as per 2018 figure, we have 2.2% disability ratio in India. Moreover, 94% of the children with disability did not receive any educational services. Out of this proportion, 94% of the children do not have any access to educational services, which is itself a very sad picture. World Bank states that almost all children with disability do not continue their education past primary school. World Bank reports that children with disability do not get opportunity to continue their education after the primary school due to one or the other reason. Then 75% of the people with disability live in rural area. Then less than 15% of the national services for people with disability are located in a rural area. We are saying that 75% of the people with disability are living in the rural area, but we don't have the access to good services for them. Less than 15% of the services are available in these areas. Moreover, the services which are available are very expensive and private one. So the children with disability or the people with disability cannot have access to these services easily. Next, 68% of the girls with disability are not in school. We have more problem with the girl population, as 68% of the girls with disability are not even they don't enter the school. Next, people with intellectual disability are the most sufferers, with the lowest enrollment, least likely to be employed and get married. Now we have problem with the intellectual disability as compared to other types of disability, as these individuals do not get an access to school education. They are the sufferers with the lowest enrollment, because no school is in a mode to give them admission due to their disability. Moreover, they don't get an employment opportunity after graduating, if they get the chance to be graduate. And moreover, they also find difficulty in starting their life and setting a career. Some hands-on experiences which will clear you the fact that we are talking about the inclusive education, but we are very far behind, as we are not experiencing the practical problems which are coming in the way of inclusive education. As reported by one teacher, at times it is very disturbing. I was teaching the class about eclipse and this blind boy was there, and I did not know how to teach him, how to tell him what is dark and what is light. I was so upset. So you can easily see the problem experienced by the teacher. Next, one disabled student, quoted by one disabled student. We were isolated. Our only activity with the other children was the weekly school assembly. That no doubt they are the part of the inclusive education, but they were isolated. We never participated in any school program. They don't get permission to participate in any school program. They just see. Next, we were in a school because children go to school. But we are outcast with no future and no expectation of one. So they are seeing their future as dark and having no expectation from their this education. Why we have such a sad picture? It can be due to some inherent problem in the system itself. First, most higher up policy maker, planners and administrators have heard of inclusion, but they do not know specific technicalities of provision in their own country. No doubt, policy makers, planners and administrators talk about the term inclusive education, but they are not clear what is the inclusive education and how to implement them. So this is the main barrier. Next, responsibility of teacher training is split between Rehabilitation Council of India Special Education and the Ministry of HRD General Education. So this split is not providing inclusion in any way. So when we are talking about the education for children with disability or with diverse needs, there are two main agencies. One is the Rehabilitation Council of India, which deals with the special education, and other is the Ministry of HRD General Education. So sometime due to not a common consensus, many problems occur in the way of implementation of inclusive education. Next, there is a problem of curriculum. Two main types of curriculum are in practice: plus curriculum, which are specifically designed for the children with special needs, like we have braille language, sticks, bold prints, audio aids, wheelchair, standing frames, etc. for the children with their disability, and a general curriculum. Need is to intermingle them as per need. So we have kept a special curriculum, special equipment for such children. Moreover, they have to go through the general curriculum also. So there is a need to intermingle these two different types of curriculum. Moreover, school buildings are predominantly not accessible. Only 18% of SSA schools were barrier-free. One of the most important problem that occur in the field of inclusive education is that is accessibility. For example, we don't have the ramp facility, we don't have the wheelchair for the individual having some handicap or having some physical problem. Moreover, we don't have the special equipment for the people with the visual impairment. So due to all these problems, children cannot reach these inclusive schools. Then there is a funding issue between center and state. There is always a war between center and state, taking into consideration the problem of funding. Then unclear role of NGOs, non-government organization, which are working very good in the field of inclusive education. They are sometimes not clear what they have to do or what their role is as a non-government organization for the welfare of such children. Then we have various issues related to assessment, intervention, legal, economic involvement of parents, families and community. Moreover, we have various problems which are related to the assessment of such children. Then intervention means how to make a required change in their life. Then there are some legal procedures, legal barriers. We have economic problems. We don't involve parents, families and community in the education of such children, which also occurs a barrier for the education of such children. Overall, education system is itself a problem. As you can easily see from this diagram, we have different types of problem in education system, that is rigid method of curriculum. We keep on teaching the children with the same method in spite of their differences or diversity or with special needs. Then we have inaccessible environment that we talked about in the previous slide. Then parents not involved, that we also covered. Then we have lack of teaching aids and equipment specifically for such children. Then poor quality training. No doubt in some schools we have special teachers trained in the special education program, but even then we suffer from the quality. Moreover, teachers' attitude. Teachers are not ready to welcome such children in their class, which is also a big problem. No doubt we have various problems. Even then, certain educational provisions for inclusions that can be made to include such children in mainstream can be considered as: we can have general classroom in general schools. We can include such children in the regular classroom in regular schools. Or education in general schools with adaptation and modification of curriculum transaction specifically to low vision children, hearing hard, where external aid can be used and learning disabled. Or we can include such children in the regular schools with certain modifications in case of visual handicapped, auditory handicap, or some kind of learning disability like dyslexia, dysgraphia, etc. Then education in general classroom with support from special teachers. We can teach them in general classroom by taking support of special teacher who are trained in the special education curriculum. Next, education in general classroom with part-time withdrawal for special instruction. We can also teach them in general classroom, and for some specific training we can give them opportunity to learn in some other premises. Next, education in special classroom in general schools for individualized instruction for severe and profound cases of disability. We can arrange special classroom in general schools to give individual instructions for such children who suffer from a very severe kind of disability. Next, preparation for education in general school requires special equipments and aids, resource room, resource teacher, related services and other facilities. So in general school we can provide special equipments and aids, as well as we have special resource room for such children. We have special resource teachers and other services which can be used for educating the children with special needs. Now, what are the factors that determine the success of inclusive classroom? So, what should be kept in mind while teaching these children, which help in their success in coming life? First, family school partnership. There should be a partnership between family and school. It means family and school should work hand in hand to deal with the specific kind of disability or problem of such children. Then there should be collaboration between general and special educators. If we teach these children in regular classroom, then there should be a collaboration between general and special educators. It means general educators as well as the teacher with the special education degree or training should cooperate with each other to deal with such children. Then there should be coordinated planning and communication between general and special needs staffs. There should be proper planning and communication between these two. Then there should be integrated service delivery. What kind of services we are providing to these children? They should be in an integrated form. Next, there should be ongoing training and staff development. Staff should be trained on a regular basis so that these children can be benefited from their skills or from their latest knowledge. There should be well-constructed plans that identify specific accommodations, modifications, and goals for each student. Moreover, we should have a well-constructed plan which should focus on the accommodation, modification and goals for each student suffering from certain kind of disability or having a distinct or different needs. Moreover, we should provide quality instructions to such children. Then we should have a wholesome emotional climate. We should understand the emotional needs of such children. Only then we can engage them in the process of teaching and learning. Next, the most important is the respecting diversity. We have to respect and celebrate their diversity. We should not outcast any individual on the basis of his belongingness to a particular caste, color, creed, culture, or any kind of disability. Then we have appropriate assessment methods. Moreover, assessment methods should be appropriate. They should focus on the qualitative assessment, not on quantitative assessment, as these children are not as quick in their responding, or they are not as perfect to give examinations in a traditional mode. So we have to assess them in a qualitative manners. Thanks. Now, if we have to conclude, just focus on these three lines. Tell me, I will forget. If you only tell me, then there is a chance that I will forget. Show me, I may remember. But if you show me, I may remember. If you help me to learn something, it may happen that I will remember this thing. Then last, involve me and I will understand. And the best strategy is, if you involve me in the learning process, then I will understand fully. So while teaching in inclusive education scenario or dealing with such children, we have to use the aspect of involve me, so that they can understand well. We can only cross this divide if we work on the principle of involving them in the process of teaching and learning. Once again, thanks, my dear students.
A mediocre teacher explains, a good teacher demonstrates, and a great teacher inspires. A journey which began over 100 years ago, this is the story of Guru Har Gobind Sahib Khalsa College, also known as the Wonder in Rural Hinterland.
ਨੈਲ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਅਤੇ ਮੈਂ ਇੱਥੋਂ ਦਾ ਜੰਮਪਲ ਹਾਂ ਔਰ ਇੱਥੇ ਹੀ ਸਕੂਲਿੰਗ ਹੈ ਮੇਰੀ ਮੈਂ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਗਰਾਊਂਡਾਂ 'ਚ ਖੇਡਿਆ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਕਮਰਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪੜ੍ਹਿਆ ਹੈਗਾ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਕਮਰਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਰਿਪੇਅਰ ਜਦੋਂ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਸੀ ਛੱਤਾਂ ਵਗੈਰਾ ਦੀ ਤਾਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਹੱਥਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕ੍ਰੈਸ਼ਰ ਪਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਸੀਮੈਂਟ ਪਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਇੱਟਾਂ ਫੜਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਯੂ ਕਾਂਟ ਥਿੰਕ ਆਫ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਸਟੇਜ ਤੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਸਟੇਜ ਤੱਕ ਆ ਗਏ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਬਖਤਾਵਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ੀਡੈਂਟ ਰਹੇ ਇਸ ਕਾਲਜ ਦੇ ਅਤੇ ਮੇਰੇ ਪਿਤਾ ਜੀ ਕਲਾਸ ਫੈਲੋ ਸੀਗੇ ਔਰ ਫਸਟ ਬੈਚ ਦੇ ਇਹ ਸਟੂਡੈਂਟ ਸੀਗੇ ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਫਰੀ ਆਫ ਕੋਸਟ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਕਈ ਪੜ੍ਹਦੇ ਰਹੇ ਔਰ ਉਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਖਾਣਾ ਵੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਫਰੀ ਮਿਲਦਾ ਸੀ ਹੋਸਟਲ ਫੈਸਿਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਇੱਥੇ ਸੀਗੀਆਂ ਇਸ ਦਾ ਜੰਗਲ ਲਾਈਕ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਸੀਗਾ ਸਾਡੇ ਦੇਖਣ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਜੰਗਲ ਲਾਈਕ ਔਰ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੇ ਇੰਨੀ ਸੋਚ ਸਾਡੀ ਮੈਨੇਜਮੈਂਟ ਦੀ ਤਾਂ ਬਖਤਾਵਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਗਿੱਲ ਮਈ ਜੂਨ ਦੇ ਮਹੀਨਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਧੁੱਪੇ ਬੈਠੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਸੀ ਕਿੱਕਰਾਂ ਦੀ ਛਾਂ ਥੱਲੇ ਔਰ ਨਾਲ ਦੀ ਨਾਲ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਾਉਂਦੇ ਸੀ ਬੜੀ ਦੇਣ ਹੈ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੀ। ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਕਾਲਜ ਹੈਗਾ ਇਹ ਰੂਰਲ ਨਾ ਸਮਝੋ ਇਹਨੂੰ, ਇਟਸ ਮੋਰ ਦੈਨ ਏ ਯੂਨੀਵਰਸਿਟੀ ਯੂ ਨੋ।